Yes, and Mr. Duke, please stand here, please.
Regarding the 6 month long credit based internship, first question is, when do you think the students can do this? Second question is, how do you
think? Let's go step by step. I will answer, you can ask the next question, okay? So either it can be done in the, as per my proposal, either in the 6th semester or 8th semester. Next.
What about the courses in the 6th semester?
Yeah, as the new UG curriculum revamp, the current ranking and council has proposed. So, the core courses which are to be done in the 6th semester will be done by the student in the 8th semester. And the credits which are the elective credits which are there in the 8th semester, that credits will be given to the student for the internship.
And like there is a purpose of keeping core courses in those semesters. Like what about the core courses of that semester? What are courses or something like that? The internship cannot cover all the domains, right?
So those core courses will be covered in the 8th semester, and the elective credits which are given for the 8th semester as scheduled in our BTEC curriculum, those credits will be given for the internship.
So how many credits do you propose for this 6 month long internship?
Do you know how many credits are there in the 8th semester? I think there are 24.
24.
You're planning that the entire 24 credits should be converted
for this internship.
And then what about the 424 credits that are already present in that semester?
What about the
courses that are already present in the semester? You will add those credits to the final credits.
No, see, in 6th semester there are some core courses, right?
Yes.
Those core courses will be done in the 8th semester. And whatever are the credits given for 8th semester, right now as there are 4 courses, elective, department elective, 24 credits. Let me complete. Those 24 credits will be given for the internship.
No, there is something wrong with your statement.
You are saying that 6th semester ke courses 8th mein karega, 7th ke 7th mein karega.
No, you should give me a chance to complete, please. So as the damp team and our department council has proposed some core shift, I think you might be knowing, they are proposing the SAMT lab to be shifted in the 4th semester along with the BMC course, and also the transportation 2 course in the 4th semester. So in spite of that change, what I am proposing is, we'll put the transportation course in the 6th semester itself, and we'll push the geotechnical course, geotech 1 into semester 4 and geotech 2 from semester 6 to semester 5.
Okay, first of all, there is a very big difference in what DAM team has proposed and what will get accepted. First of all, we as a DAM team member, we didn't know what will get accepted in the meeting. So I think we should focus on the current plan and then answer the questions. Do you think it is correct or not?
It's correct.
That plan is not valid till now, and I think even in your tenure it won't get executed.
And secondly, if it
gets completed, it will get accepted for the next batch.
And if you are
have the curriculum review committee said that they will accept this or consider this?
It will be discussed.
It will be considered for discussion.
Yes, it will be considered.
Okay, so in that
consideration is a very different thing than execution.
Everything starts from consideration.
Yes, everything starts from
consideration. So we have to start somewhere.
We cannot start the planning totally based on that. So even after the proposed changes, you are suggesting multiple more changes to that.
No, I am not suggesting multiple changes. I am just suggesting one change so that which is the prerequisite for this foundation engineering course that gets completed in the 5th semester itself. I am not proposing multiple changes.
In
the 8th semester.
Eight semester. What do that person do in the internship? Foundation is after the internship. Law school is also after the internship.
So it will depend upon the student to student. Why do you want to make the?
Yes.
So, I want the students to make the
DOSKI. Firstly, DOSKI is a very important structural design course. If a person is planning a 6 month long internship, let's say if the industry is structural design. This is my personal opinion. I am pretty sure that most of your people here will agree that DOSKI is an important course.
Yeah,
I also
agree, it's important.
But you know, your plan does not leave any space to pursue DOSKI, right?
There are many important things and we can't include everything, isn't it?
Yeah, so don't you feel it's more feasible to kind of exclude the idea of semester, like semester long internship that would be pursued by, let's say, 5 at max, instead of like kind of jeopardizing the academic life of 120 students?
Then what is the number expected? Three students carrying a system that
is. Let's say there are 5, let's say even there are 10 people who want to pursue 6 months, I am pretty sure there would be more than 10 people who want to do this, okay? And you are putting core courses in the 8th semester. Out of the remaining 110 people, what if people fail those courses in 8th semester? They will have to face a 7th semester.
And the first point is, what are the 110 people doing? So, 8-10 people are going to 6-month internship. So, the rest of the people are experiment.
Obviously, they are regular things.
No.
So, you are going to
have
two
department electives in that sense.
See, you are not, means you didn't get
okay,
my idea
so
completely.
You can clarify on that point once again and then we'll ask questions.
Yeah, so everything is running smoothly. Only the students who are doing this particular internship, they will be doing the 6 semester courses in the 8th semester, and the 8th semester elective credits will be given for this internship which is during the 6th semester.
And can you again, okay, this is when your plan of course revamp, curriculum revamp takes place, right?
This is not curriculum revamp plan, this is just an...
So right now, like you're saying...
A very facility.
Third year is basically.
So you are saying right now we can put this, like this can be implemented without, like, next semester if there is no curriculum change, we can still implement this.
No, we can't because the geotechnical course is there, which is
prerequisite. Yeah, so that's exactly what we are saying, right?
That's what we are saying, right?
So it's there, we are proposing it also to be changed, isn't it?
Proposed
any
other
system,
yeah.
So like, I
have your idea or have you talked to people about it? About
like,
how
is
it?
Have you talked to HOD? Like,
the main
person
HOD? Execution by the
yes, I have talked to HOD and the GSAA who made me aware about this.
So,
for factual correction, I spoke to the... No, like one thing, I mean, no, one thing, just a second. So, you are telling me... He has no issues.
But if you talk about the logistics,
see,
you convey your logistics to the...
As far as I know, HOD is ready for 6 month long internship. If it's possible with a curriculum change, but not with a credit base. As far as
yes.
I am concerned,
this is again this comes back that you mentioned that on this point, the first point that was there, that why you do you want to make everything credit based?
Yeah.
Why not just for learning? So isn't this against your policy of making something just for?
Because here all the entire time for the student learns that all time is devoted for the internship itself.
And how many credits you will allocate for the course, this internship course?
That I already told.
Okay.
Huh?
24.
I am told
how
many times. Huh? How?
Rating.
Yes, that's what we have to discuss. We'll be taking the feedback from the students and our seniors. What actually?
You are
busy.
Professor is the one who will take a call, not students and seniors.
Yeah, definitely professor are there who will take the final call, but some inputs like what students expect from this internship.
Only call. Professors are
final call
only take the call. But they have the power, like you will assign a faculty, right, for that internship.
Okay.
And you have 24 credits. Even DDP has 36 credits.
More than that. Yes, 36 is more than 24.
Yeah,
that's what I said.
Again, but again, like you will, it is a very tedious project. So you will have to, like, how will you grade it? The faculty is, we will not be directly involved with the student. Only the person in the industry will be involved with the student. And even for the 6 credit based internships, the guidelines are not written clearly yet. So how will you make it available for 24 credits?
The student will be regularly meeting the faculty, what's the currently he's working in the internship.
So what if he's outside from?
Yes. How do you plan? The student will be meeting the faculty or the person who, he'll definitely be meeting the person who's helping him out throughout the internship.
Yes, both the persons will be meeting, what currently he's working on, and the weekly report.
So I'm limiting the region of internship to Mumbai.
No.
कैसे करेगा
they have like it's in the curriculum itself. Like I said, we the credits allocating, it's already there. Like they don't need to adjust anything. So for us now, in that way, we think it will be possible if the student completes the all the 24 credits before the 8th semester, and then in the 8th semester, the student can take up the internship.
Let's see, one thing I will add, one of the in the DGSE meetings of 27th October 2018, first point of semester long credit supply, optional or credit not yet approved by the Senate. Making it creditized, you need to work with the Senate, it won't be an easy task for it.
Just as of my, like most of our knowledge, in any university the 6 month internship which happens, it's not a credit based internship. There are 6 month internships, but they are not a credit based internship. So, next question for Pritesh. Any question for Pritesh?
This point is very vague. So, how can we allow such a point?
No to this question.
Any question for Pritesh?
Organizing group discussions in interdisciplinary interaction. So how do you attract students for that? Do you think they will turn up in their busy schedule?
So like I spoken to like one of the PhD students. So like they said like taking out 2 hours of time is a very good thing. Like it will be kind of, it is a kind of research for them as well. And coming to the part like as you are doing it for the water remote and then you have that prof has made a compulsory to do it. So we'll follow the same model, we'll tell the other professors to do it compulsory. And it will be kind of like exchange of ideas and it will be open for the easy user to also get to know what is thing happening.
Had you spoken to the professor, the respective discipline professors?
Like I spoken to only one of the professor and some of the PhD students. So say, they say that it is very good thing to do. But I have not spoken about like making it compulsory. The professor said that we need to discuss again for more of it. So it is started for the one part. I will persuade the other prof or tell them that it is being there for the other one. Professor one is allowing for this, so you should also try to allow it for the others also.
So, next question. Will it be a random discussion or will you allocate a topic first after discussing with the PhD students?
So, like, I will coordinate with the PhD representative, then they will coordinate to the respective CR of that particular group. So, either we'll choose one, so we'll take who is ready to present it.
Like,
so,
will it be random? Like, I come and then present my.
So, like, I will be letting.
So
the PhD guy who is going to represent his topic, he will let you know, we'll let you know through the. GPO or is through like social media sites.
Right, will you decide a theme for the discussion or
No, I will not decide a theme. I will just say what his research is going on. So his research is on this topic, so I will be posting that only. Not a particular theme. Can you repeat the question? Like
thesis presentations like submit होते हैं, right? APS में भी होते हैं.
APS में भी होते
हैं. तो अगर किसी को research किसी एक particular बंदे का research देखना है,
So he can come to APS.
So like in APS, the professor sit itself then, and it becomes and the student also can't ask question to the like professor sitting there. It doesn't feel good for them. And I'm trying to open it for UG. And the time conveniency will be depending mostly in the evening after evening slot, so that UGs can also attend it.
All the students are not like the professors will not invite all the students. So it's depends on the supervisor. Like it depends on the supervisor. You're saying evening slots, like post 5:30? Yeah. So we could PhD. So like we will try, huh? We will try for that also. Like we will tell the professor to make it compulsory for the PhD and MD student to come.
So like we will try for that also. Like we will tell the professor to make it compulsory for the PhD and MD student to come. No, it's hard to say it's compulsory. You cannot like pose. Ah, okay. If it was like, if that's why I'm saying the theme was so low, the chunky, like, yeah, or else, it's a session. So if a topic is over, the topic, yeah, okay, we can work. Like I will just try with the thesis. Okay, we'll work more, you know, specifically what they're saying. So like, ha, I understood your point. So we'll try with this idea. If it doesn't work, we'll try with the theme idea and let's see.
Hardcore research में UGs को इतना interest नहीं होगा, मतलब समझ भी नहीं आएगा. So हमेशा overview देने का point होता है. तो मतलब theme से लेकर interdisciplinary में क्या हो रहा है, तो theme का major idea होता है.
So like I will edit this with the PhD.
Thesis के topic रहेंगे तो बारी बारी के मतलब नहीं आएगा.
So like I will edit this with the PSE representative and get it implemented. बात करोगे
implementation?
हाँ. ये जो implementable बात की पहले. हाँ, I've spoken. क्या क्या है? ये implementable है? कैसे है? Means like the I will talk about the current scenario of the water, ocean and remote sensing. So they have approached to one of the professors and professors have made the other professors that make it compulsory to PSE student. They will be starting in a they will be starting soon and so similarly thing they will be starting it soon and it will be open for the UGs as well. So regarding the theme and all, I have not discussed, like I had a general opinion in my mind, like it would be like one of them would be speaking on a general idea like about his thesis only.
Unka,
first point in academic reforms push for course restructuring during syllabus review. So what does course restructuring entails exactly, and do you as a student representative have any power over course restructuring, or like even more, like is it kind of, does it make sense for students to restructure course suiting themselves, or should we let this responsibility rest on professors?
Yeah.
Some of the courses, if there are some new techniques introduced in recent years, that can be added to the course. That's what I mean by course restructuring.
So are you aware of some new techniques, or you will ask the professors to do that?
It will be a survey will be conducted among students. The feedback can
be. Professors are more aware of the new techniques than the students.
Definitely, professors are.
So, what are you going to remind them before every course? Please search for some new techniques. Or
it's not required for every course.
What, see, restructuring ka matlab bas yehi hai kya ki you will include new ideas, matlab new tech, and even that is not covering everything. Matlab new tech, or most of the professors who want to explain to students, they usually include a slide or two regarding that. So, what is this course restructuring?
Point
ये है,
पूरा groundwork समझा अच्छे से, मतलब what is your groundwork on that?
So when I did groundwork with third year students about some of the courses, their output was like the syllabus content is lesser, or some new things can be included in this, those particular things.
Can you give an example which course and what
I don't think it is appropriate to take the course name and the professor name and by the content.
I'm not asking for the professor's name, I'm just asking for the course.
The course on geotechnical engineering.
What examples should be added?
Huh?
Yeah. What new ideas?
What new idea should be added to geotechnical
engineering? Like that thing will be decided by the professor, but the course content right now is very less.
So basically, what you are doing is going to professors and telling them that एंड बेसिकली हां यही हो रहा है ना कि तूने स्टूडेंट से सर्वे कराया वोट लिया और प्रोफेसर को जाके तूने ये बोला कि व्हाट यू आर टीचिंग राइट नाउ इज नॉट गुड एनफ
No, not at all. I didn't mention not good enough. I said,
you didn't mention, but
let me answer. You should have patience to listen to me. I just said if the content is lesser, some new things can be added to it. When did I say that the professor is not teaching good enough?
Example, why you can have
option? Yeah, geotech 2 is
good.
मोटिवेशन ये है कि जब मैं स्टूडेंट से पूछा तो स्टूडेंट्स ने ये बताया कि कुछ कोर्सेज में कंटेंट बहुत कम है उसमें कुछ नई चीज़ें डाली जा सकती है जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल जैसे जियोडेसी का कोर्स है उसमें जो सेकंड हाफ पार्ट रहता है उसमें ट्रायंगल हाइट्स वगैरह की चीज़ें ज्योमेट्रिक बेसिकली उसमें कुछ इसका तो एक GIS इंक्लूड किया जा सकता है इंटरव्यू लेवल पे
Have you talked to any professor regarding this?
No. So like coming to factual correction, he is talking about the GIS part. There is one course running on GIS a student can take. And other thing is like, I have spoken to the professor and professor has said that we will introduce GIS to the student, but it will be kind of informal session, but we won't do too much load on the student or geodesy. It is not that like all the students cope up with the syllabus introducing GIS. You are thinking about only some part of the student, you don't thinking of the other aspect. So we need to be on the middle and think of all the students.
In fact, last year, I think the professor wanted to change the name of the course to survey and include only those mathematical geometry
parts. Yes, geodesy is actually a different thing which is not actually being taught in that course. So yeah, the course name is being changed. In fact, it has been discussed in the years.
So my only point is, if the content is lesser and students feel that something more can be taught, that
yes,
will be informed to the
students. What exactly?
How many courses are we targeting? What do
you have to compare?
Who gives the?
No, this is the lesser.
Sorry,
I answer.
The students who have done that course already.
Yes.
How
did
they
know
content कम है क्योंकि उनकी अच्छी
grade
है इसका मतलब content कम है.
You also ask students who got an FR maybe a 4 or 5 in that course.
Geodesy
में
नहीं.
Students who got FR.
FR 4 or maybe 5 or 6 in it. Did you ask them if
the content was inadequate?
No, actually, because for them the question is questions were like slot clashes and how the courses can be covered up against slot clashes.
So basically, this point ka crux abhi tak nahi mila ki do you even have power to do that? Aur matlab abhi tak ye bas suggestion pe kaam kar raha hai na? Bas suggestion
pe kar raha hai. Should you have the power? Should students have the power? Nahi bol raha. Students ko
स्टूडेंट्स
Students
say review यही होता
है कि class में कम
समझ में
आया
ज़्यादा समझ में आया.
Have you talked
to our
old
batch? Are they happy with the current
scenario and geometry? After so, you know, made whatever changes.
They are.
Who said
you?
Who are?
Our
time
we watch
it.
Huh? Our time we watch it.
Our time
we watch it. What is the official procedure for like changing syllabus?
Curriculum revamp is going to happen in the coming summer for the next batch. So in that batch, whatever are the inputs from the current students, that will be given to that committee and they will consider and add it if they find it correct.
ये student survey पे based होगा, जो मतलब major जो तेरा होगा, है ना?
अगर अगला बैच डिसएग्री करता है
obviously
तो professors को ज़्यादा आता है ना। I didn't say final call will be always professors, but a student always has a right.
The whole point of this discussion is even a student representative does not have a power to change the course structure.
But he definitely has a power to express, isn't it?
Nahi, express may be because,
he doesn't have.
Because try to understand the reason behind it. Student representative ko ek saal ka experience ho us course ka. Professor 20 saal se padha raha hai wo course.
Even senior professors karte syllabus review. Wo bhi nahi karte jo naye aate hain. Wo log bhi nahi draft karte. जो लोग पढ़ाते पढ़ाए भी नहीं इस साल उससे पहले वाले जो प्रोफेसर है वो करते
माई स्टैंड इज ओनली दैट for changes students think or from their point of view that will be conveyed to the faculty, obviously their call is the final call.
Which students are these whose opinions you want to convey to the faculty, and is this student a monolithic group which has a unanimous decision on which direction the course should go, or will there be disagreements?
You cannot take an opinion of...
Can you please stop one at a time? One at a time, please.
You cannot take opinion of one student and say to a professor that I am representing the class as a whole.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
This is a very wrong thing. If you...
What is wrong thing?
I think everybody wants to listen to Ayush question. So when, who will this student be and whose opinions will you go with to the professor?
All the students' feedback will be taken from all the students. If there is, there should not be some cursing or some bad thing. Just everything which is proper, like some student may feel the syllabus good, some may think the bad, some may think everything will be conveyed.
So there will be contradictory opinions.
There can be. As of now, there are among us. You see, always there will be.
So whose opinion will be?
It's faculty stand finally. We will convey.
So one point of interruption. So you are a student representative, everything will be done by the faculty, then what will you do in this thing then?
And is it like you just mentioned in the course review you fill at the end, I guess there is like enough subjective points where you can...
That is anonymous. There is a reason for that. People can write their feelings about courses. Now you take a survey, the blame comes on you. Like this happened...
Not even on you, it comes on the student council. You as an individual might, let's say in a hypothetical condition, push your own agendas, but the whole council and the student body gets like is answerable to that. So that's what we are concerned about, that this is I don't think at all feasible or necessary.
I think what you should focus on is that students should fill the course feedback form on ASC more genuinely. Because the problem with the institute in general is that students don't fill the feedback form, and secondly, even if they do, they just do it to see their grades.
Yeah, definitely. For that, what I was proposing is in the last class of every course, some particular 10 minutes slot will be given to the students to compulsorily get the feedback. So you are talking about ASC feedback, right? That's what I'm telling to complete that since the students are not feeling, I'm proposing in the last class of that particular course, some 10 minutes window can be given to the students and they can compulsorily fill the feedback there.
Okay. So first rule is that you cannot make it compulsory. Even ASC may be an option that you don't want to give feedback.
We can ask them please fill this if they don't want to.
ठीक है एक फाइनल क्वेश्चन दोनों के लिए उसके बाद
क्वेश्चन ये मैनिफेस्टो में मास्टर्स और पीएचडी स्टूडेंट्स के लिए कुछ दिखा नहीं है, मतलब